If becoming stinkingly rich is your aim as a young person, that's not a dream you should focus on so much. In my few years of studying really wealthy people, people who succeed ethically, they spend a lot of time solving real problems for people. They were so focused on finding solutions to the problems of people, and so, in the long run, they made so much money. Not that they weren't desperate to be rich, but that desperation was often filled by a desire to solve a problem for people, and so, they became stinkingly rich. Personally, I have to admit straight out that I don't want to be stinkingly rich. I just want to have enough money to become comfortable and help others with. If you aim to be rich, I will share with you 7 success secrets from self-made billionaires in today's video. Subscribe to this channel so you don't miss other interesting videos like this. 1. Dream big. Richard Branson. Every great success starts with a big dream. Bill Gates' dream was to see personal computers in every home. Your journey to great wealth begins with catching a dream that leads you on. British billionaire and entrepreneur Sir Richard Branson, founder of Virgin Group of Companies, said, "Dreaming is one of humanity's greatest gifts. It champions aspiration, spurs innovation, leads to change, and propels the world forward. There would be no art in the world without dreams. No adventure, no moon landing, no female CEOs, and no civil rights. What a half-lived and tragic existence we would have. The benefits of dreaming far outweigh the perceived risk because the value of dreaming isn't just measured by the outcome, but the inspiration that comes from the journey of achieving the dream." 2. Be willing to make big bets. Mark Zuckerberg. Being a self-made success will always require risks. Entrepreneurship is a risk. That is why tons of people never step into that water, and most who step into it and fail hardly want to take great risks. Most self-made billionaires will boast about losing all at one time and thinking it was over, but they chose to remain steadfastly committed to their dreams of creating a successful business. When Facebook launched the newsfeed feature in 2006, millions of users didn't agree with the idea, but Mark Zuckerberg and his team didn't give in. They chose to follow that risk through until people admitted their idea. Mark Zuckerberg said, "One of the things I'm most proud of about Facebook is that we believe things can always be better, and we're willing to make big bets if we think it will help our community over the long term. Newsfeed has been one of the big bets we've made in the past 10 years that has shaped our community and the whole internet the most." 3. Love the journey. Richard Branson. If you aren't enjoying the journey towards success, you can't succeed. Most people want to succeed in doing what they don't love. It's the same reason why they would be frustrated on their way to succeeding. If you find what you love doing, you will love the journey towards success, because on the journey towards success, there will be so many challenges, and only by doing what you love will you at least find some courage to stay through the tide. When Richard Branson wrote about the closing of the Virgin American brand, he celebrated the process of building the airline. "This was the ride and love of a lifetime. I feel very lucky to have been on it with all of you." 4. Obsess over the details. Steve Jobs. Apple Inc. is known as one of the most excellent companies in the world, notable for producing products that usually have users literally queue up to buy right before launch. The reason for this great success is not far-fetched. The man behind the Apple Inc. idea was a man who was greatly concerned about details, Kara Swisher. The executive editor of Recode admits that Steve Jobs was reputed to be a ruthless man, but that was a result of his obsession with perfection. Kara Swisher said, "People used to say he, Steve Jobs, was heartless. I think he had too much heart. You know what I mean? He cared too much. He had so much heart that he couldn't stand it when things weren't right." If we don't pay attention to what we're doing, we can't discover how best we can do it so we can do it better. Michael Dell of Dell Computers once said in an interview that he would travel the world to hire the man who is best at what he does, because there will be little problems with such a man. You have to be willing to be such a person if you're truly interested in becoming stinking rich. 5. Seek out simple solutions. Bill Gates. Over the years, this is what I have found. Success is contained in doing simple things, not the big things. For example, most people think hard work is what brings success. Slugging behind the work desk for 24 hours with no time to rest until you burn out isn't the recipe for success. Smart work is. Bill Gates, co-founder of Microsoft, said in his 2007 Harvard commencement address, "The barrier to change is not too little caring, it is too much complexity. To turn caring into action, we need to see a problem, see a solution, and see the impact. But complexity blocks all three steps. Finding solutions is essential if we want to make the most of our caring. If we have clear and proven answers anytime an organization or individual asks, 'How can I help?' then we can get action, and we can make sure that none of the caring in the world is wasted. But complexity makes it hard to mark a path of action for everyone who cares, and that makes it hard for their caring to matter." 6. Focus is everything. Steve Jobs. It's the challenge of young people who desire to succeed in wanting to try so many things at the same time. I tried to do this for so many years, but kept failing. I didn't know why until I realized I was always starting one thing this week, quitting it next week, and starting another. Focus, focus, focus. This is the key to success. An explanation for why Steve Jobs was the person who influenced him most, Tim Cook said, Steve Jobs had a focus that was unlike any other. He could focus so intensely because of his ability to prioritize. His thinking was so pure. He wasn't trying to maximize his wealth or anything else. 7. Be yourself, Richard Branson. If you can't be yourself, you can't be successful. Neither can you stay successful, because you will almost always be intimidated by others who are doing better than you. It is easier to be yourself when you know yourself. You know your capabilities and weaknesses, and you are content to work in those areas. That way, you never have to worry when someone seemingly outshines you in your field, because you know that you're unique. So is the other person. Richard Branson suffers from dyslexia. He has had to learn to embrace his uniqueness rather than allow it to be an impediment. He said, "Yourself is always the best version of you, and being yourself is among the best advice I have ever received." He also said, "I've been thinking a lot about the meaning of life and about the things I want to teach my grandchildren so that they live the best life possible." The Virgin founder and chairman says he keeps coming back to a quote from the children's book, Happy Birthday to You, by Dr. Seuss. Today, you are you. That is truer than true. There is no one alive who is youer than you. If this video inspired you, like the video. We love you.